Let's talk about the stockholders' equity section of a balance sheet. So we have this example problem that says Carter Company has the following balances in their stockholders' equity accounts on December 31st, 2020. So we're given information for common stock, paid in capital in excess of par for both common and preferred, preferred stock, retained earnings, and treasury stock. So we're going to use all of that information to prepare the stockholders' equity section of the balance sheet at December 31st, 2020. So this is what the stockholders' equity section of a balance sheet would look like. And before we start plugging in all of the numbers, let's just take a look at the format. So your stockholders' equity is made up of a few different pieces. It's your paid-in capital and your retained earnings added together, and then you subtract out your treasury stock. Now, paid-in capital is made up of a few different pieces as well. First, your capital stock. So that's your preferred stock and your common stock. That's stock that you have issued. Additional paid in capital, those are your paid in capital in excess of par or paid in capital in excess of stated value. Those would fall under additional paid in capital. Then you add up your capital stock and your additional paid in capital to get your total paid in capital. So now let's start plugging in some of the numbers. So we can see that our preferred stock up in the upper left is $950,000. So we will put that in our balance sheet. Common stock is $2,400,000. So then our total capital stock is preferred stock plus common stock, which gets us $3,350,000. So that's your capital stock portion done. So now we can move on to the additional paid-in capital. So we have our paid-in capital in excess of par for preferred stock. That's $500,000. Paid-in capital in excess of par for common stock is $1,500,000. So your total additional paid-in capital will be $2,000,000. Now we need to find our total paid-in capital. Again, paid in capital is made up of capital stock and additional paid in capital. So your total paid in capital will be your $3,350,000 plus $2,000,000. So we get $5,350,000. Now we move on to the next piece that makes up our stockholders' equity. That's our retained earnings. So we have retained earnings in this example of $800,000. Then our total paid in capital and retained earnings will be the $5 million plus $800,000. So we get $6,150,000. Then we want to subtract out our treasury stock. Again, treasury stock, that's stock that you purchased back from your shareholders. So we're going to subtract that out here. We were told that our treasury stock was $200,000. And then we can find our total stockholders' equity of $5,950,000.